to talk to tomatoes. If a squash can make you smile. If you like to waltz with potatoes. Up and down the produce aisle. Hey, excuse me. Have we got a show for you?
Children he could call his own.
I call this one.
That's not a child. His three beloved brothers were mysteriously lost at sea while delivering meatballs to the small island of Boyardee. So Gelato poured all of his loneliness and love into the toys he carved for the joy of others. One of the toys, a wooden duck, was so realistic, a family of motherless ducklings followed it home. Gelato loved the ducks like they were his own children. Oh, how he loved to teach them, and oh, how they loved to listen. He taught them about right and wrong, responsibility, honesty,
and monopoly. Greg is fascinated with real estate.
Cricket was glad Gelato was happier, even though ducks made him nervous.
They eat caterpillars!
Well, good thing you're a cricket.
I have got to change my name.
And so the ducklings listened closely as Gelato taught them everything they needed to know.
Look at little Liliana as her mother shows her how to gather breakfast from a chicken or make milkshakes from a cow. Even Stephen's struggling papa taught him when to take a bow. Wow. Nothing's missing because they listen when their parents taught them how. A mother and a father know the ways to live life right. So listen, little children, and your days will turn out bright. Now you. Wonderful. Now harmonize. Beautiful. Now pick Latin. Perfect. Now barbershop. Ears and in your heart to teach you what is true. A father loves his little ones, he'll teach them what is right. And if you listen closely, then your days will turn out right. Listen, little ducklings, and your life will turn out right.
Psst, Gelato.
Parcheesi, how's the woodworking business?
Oh, I love the smell. Hate the splinters.
You can say that again.
Hate the splitters. Say, you wouldn't need a nice piece of wood, would you?
Would I? But I can't, so I won't. I've only got 5 pennies right now. We don't spend money we don't have, right, duckling?
Oh, it's your lucky day, Gelato. This very special piece is yours, absolutely free.
Huh? Nothing's free, Parcheesi.
True, except this piece of wood.
Wow.
Oh, dear.
Must be Mexican jumping wood.
It's pistachio wood. From a pistachio tree. Very special.
Well, at least you could let me pay you a little something, Parcheesi. Parcheesi?
No need to pay. It's all yours.
Something smells fishy.
No, it smells like pistachios. Hooray! A bonus piece of wood for a bonus toy. Come, little ducklings. Daddy's gonna carve you a brother.
This has bad idea written all over it.
Really? Must be tiny writing. Good night, little ones. Bruce, let's hope that beak guard helps your snoring. Gary, it's not polite to eat worms in bed. Good night, Greg. Sweet dreams, little ones. Prepare yourself for a long night, Cricket.
All throughout the night, Gelato poured his love into this new and very special wood.
Happiness without anybody's help.
Oh, Pistachio, You need to listen to those who love you the most, your parents.
Why should I listen to my parents? I want what's best for me.
Because you are too young to know what is best for you, Pistachio. Trust me, I was a boy once, too. Tomorrow, we'll take a field trip for your first lesson in life. But for now, we must sleep.
Well, okay. I guess we can try it your way. For now.
That's my log, boy. Good night, Cricket.
I am a caterpillar.
Good night, Pistachio.
You will see. Gelato is a good father. He has learned great things from his own father. And you will learn those things from him. If you will listen.
Well, if I don't, I'm not hanging around a bunch of ducks.
A team.
What?
It's not a bunch of ducks. It is a team of ducks. Like a gaggle of geese or a herd of cattle.
Never heard of cattle.
Oh, I've got a bad feeling about this.
So Gelato took his ducklings and Pistachio to the art museum, where he would use the paintings to teach a very important lesson.
Just pictures? Boring.
You'll see, Pistachio. There's nothing like art to help you find your way. Hey, Art!
Aye! What's up, Gelato?
Which way to the sheep paintings?
Down and to the left, past the prodigal.
Thanks, Art. Gary, you should have gone before we left home. Now, here's what I really wanted to show you. Sheep!
Never heard of sheep.
It's a flock of sheep. You're thinking of cattle. It was the shepherd's job to take care of 100 sheep. One sheep ran away and got lost. Even though there were still 99 more, the shepherd left the 99 to go off into a storm in search of that one lost sheep.
Why would he do that?
Well, because he was a good shepherd, and he loved all the sheep. He didn't want to lose a single one.
Why did the little sheep run away?
Nobody knows. Maybe a wolf dressed like a sheep talked him into it. Maybe he thought he could find something more fun than following his shepherd. Maybe he thought he knew best. By the time the shepherd found him, he was cold and miserable. He knew he should have listened to the shepherd.
Some children act the same way. They foolishly think they know best, that they don't need to listen to their parents. Not me. I'm no fool. No, sorry.
Nicely put, Cricket. You should sit on my mallet and finish all of my stories.
Moralizing runs very deep in my family.
Is in one of those art books, and they're only 5 cents. I'd be happy to go buy it for you. Can I have 5 cents? Huh, can I?
Wow, that's great that you've taken an interest in art so soon, but 5 cents is all the money I have.
But it's filled with artwork that we could take home. I thought you wanted your children to learn. I want to learn all I can.
Hey, don't look at me. I cannot even lift a penny.
So Gelato gave Pistachio his 5 pennies to buy the book, but made him promise to go straight there and then come right back.
Oh, I promise.
The moment he lied, something strange happened to Pistachio's nose. But we'll get to that later.
Growing boy.
Okay, now, who can tell me the population of Luxembourg? Oh, close, Greg, but you forgot the suburbs.
Come young, come old, my puppets down the hall to the fun that you're not supposed to have. I'll do some impressions, but there won't be boring lessons like the ones that you get from your dad. As silly as a tickle,
sorry, tickets cost a nickel, a small price to pay to be glad.
So come see my talents.
Abandon your parents.
It's fun,
and it's no strings attached.
New string!
Huh?
Amazing! A puppet with no strings! If you were in the show, I'd be rich! Picture people paying golden coins to watch this little boy as he sings for them and dances as the world's first stringless toy. It's so genius, just between us, everyone will cry encore!
Encore!
Boy, it's no time to be modest, and the world will soon applaud us. Look at what you brought us.
Caterpillar.
Remember the painting?
seeking of the lost sheep, like any good shepherd. I love all my children the same. That means you, and Pistachio too. I won't rest until we're all home, no matter what.
Better make that corn dog to go.
And now it's time for obscure Broadway show tunes with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings an obscure Broadway show tune. Without further ado, from the unknown musical Office Supplies, the heart-rending love song, Where Have All the Staplers Gone?
We don't have much time before the big meeting.
No, we don't.
Have you seen the scissors, miss?
They're in the bottom drawer.
I tried that drawer, but they're there no more.
That's odd.
I know, I thought for sure.
Have you seen the masking tape?
It's right next to the phone.
That's what I thought, but now it's not. I guess I should have known.
Oh, where have all the staplers gone? What happened to our paper clips?
The ballpoint pens are gone again.
They're gone again. The sticky pads have lost their stick. Rubber bands were in their place.
They're in the middle drawer.
Light bulbs easy to replace.
Yes,
there were always more.
Sheets of paper raining down.
Legal pads aplenty.
Highlighters in every hue.
I remember. Ever less than 20. Oh, where have all the staplers gone? What happened to our paper clips? The ballpoint pens are gone again. We've run out of packing slips.
Someday my prints will come.
Please replace the toner.
Someday we'll find more.
Vanilla folders.
Someday my prints will come.
Where's the printer cable?
Someday we'll find more of
adhesive shipping labels.
In search of his little lost duckling.
Wooden boy.
While something entirely less noble was going on at the carnival.
He loses again. Two in a row.
Again? I give up. I think it's probably best to just go home.
Wait! You still have 3 gold coins.
But...
on your own. Can't give up. That's 3 more coins. That's better luck. If you return to your father empty-handed, you'll only disappoint and then be reprimanded. You must show.
Oh,
not sung.
You're not sung.
You're more tough.
You're more tough.
You'll win big.
Really, really big.
You'll play rough.
Rough, 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 rough.
Don't need,
you don't need
your father's love.
No need to listen to your dad. You know enough. You've got go. Minus one. You'll get paid. You'll have fun.
Oops, not again. Oh, ain't that rough?
No need to listen to your dad. You know enough.
He's on his own. I can't give up. Have you seen him? Or am I out of luck? He needs a dad to help him make it through. And since that's who I am, that's what I'm gonna do.
You? It's true.
The bookseller told Gelato that she had seen a strange wooden boy headed for the waterfront. This troubled Gelato, who was afraid Pistachio might fall into the sea and float off like driftwood. He thanked the woman and was off.
You're not broke.
You're not broke.
You're just close.
You're just close.
You haven't spent all of your gold
just almost.
But even if you run out of your stuff, no need to listen to your dad.
You know enough. Again! Ha! This is my lucky night!
Oh no! I can't go home to Gelato with nothing!
Good thing there's one game where you can win riches beyond your wildest dreams!
But we only have one gold coin left!
That's all it takes, Pistachio. One gold coin.
But that's everything!
You're in deep, you're all alone.
Almost sunk.
I won't give up.
You've got a golden coin, but need a little luck.
Oh dear, where are you?
Follow us.
I'll brave the sea.
Now it is rough.
Bring you back to me.
No need to listen to your dad. You know enough. No need to listen to your dad. You know enough.
Pistachio, you and you alone are not enough.
Quite scary. But isn't that what you wanted?
I thought it was.
Oh, well, Gelato's probably already forgotten about you. I bet he's got other kids that listen.
How do you play?
Oh, simple, really. You sit in this car and advance up the ramp every time you answer a question correctly. The